Good day, everyone. I am Marlita Sanchez-Ramoso from Bachelor of Secondary Education, Major in Social Studies, Second Year, Set A. And this is my output in SSE 202, Macroeconomics. Today, I will discuss and demonstrate the calculation of GDP and expenditure in value-added approach. Here's our main objectives for today's discussion. At the end of the discussion, the students will be able to know how to calculate GDP in expenditure and GDP on value-added approach. Here's now the set of problems. Number one, from the data below, what is the total GDP expenditure of the Philippines? Number two, fill the missing value. Number three, fill the missing values in the table below and find the total value added at all stages of production. For number 1, we have net exports, 4 million, net imports, 6 million, investment, 185 million, government spending, 195 million, and the consumption is 500 million. So in order to get the GDP expenditure, we need to use this formula. GDP equals to C stands for consumption, plus I, investment, plus G, the government spending, and the close in open parenthesis, X minus M. X for the net exports and M for the net imports. So it goes like this. 500 plus 185 plus 195. Close in open parenthesis, 4 minus 6. So we will use the PEMDAS. 6 minus 4 is equals to 2. And the 500 plus 185 plus 195 is equals to 880. So 880 minus 2, the answer is 878. So the total GDP expenditure of the Philippines is 878 million. For number 2, we need to fill the missing value. So we have the real interest rate, nominal interest rate, and the inflation. So for number 1, we need to get the inflation. So in order to get the inflation, we need this formula. Nominal interest rate minus the real interest rate. So 7 minus 5 is equals to 2. So the inflation is 2. For number 2, we need to get the nominal interest rate. So real interest rate plus inflation, then 4 plus 3 is equals to 7. So the nominal interest rate is 7. For the third one, is we need to get the real interest rate. So the formula is nominal interest rate minus inflation. So 12 minus 9 is equals to 3. So the real interest rate is 3. For number 3, we need to fill the missing values in the table below. So we have the cost of input, price of output, and the value added. So in the first one, growing oranges. So the both blank is 8 pesos. It's because when we subtract 8 minus 8, it is equals to 0. And when we add 8 plus 0, it is equals to 8. Making orange juices. It is 8 pesos. It's because 10 minus 2 is equals to 8. And when we subtract 10 minus 8 is equals to 2. Distributing juice to store. It is 15 pesos and 5 pesos. Why? It's because 10 pesos plus 5 pesos is equals to 15 pesos. And 15 pesos minus 10 pesos is equals to 5 pesos. While in selling juice to consumer, it is 18.50. It's because 10 pesos plus 3.50 is equals to 18.50. And when 18.50 minus 10 pesos is equals to 3.50. So it is right. And for the total, cost of input, 33 pesos. Price of output, 51.50. Value added is 18.50. In addition, here's my ways or formula in order to get the missing values. For the price of output, I just add the cost of input in the value added. Cost of input, I just subtract the price of output in the value added. And for the value added, I just subtract the price of output in the cost of input.
And that would be all. Thank you, and once again, good day.